Have you ever seen anything like this? Completely, when it's given that this report also focused on other countries and violence against children.
Well, it's certainly most shocking and appalling. But let me first say this. I commend the UN for this report. It's so crucial that we have verifiable facts in a report. We have now a basis to discuss about. And of course, the facts that were reported are appalling. The fact that the Syrian security forces targeted children not older than 9 years old for killing, for maiming, for arbitrary detention, torture, and sexual abuse, that's just unspeakable and despicable. And also terrible, the way they used children as human shields. It just shows how depraved, how cruel this power struggle of the Assad regime has turned out to be.
Now, you say power struggle, and that leads me to the comment that was made earlier on today about this being a civil war. Are you in agreement with that?
Well, it just shows how vicious this circle of violence has become and how urgent it is to break that circle of violence and
to come civil war?
To a stop. Well, it's a terrible state of affairs, and it is a vicious circle of violence that we've got to break, whatever you call it, and we need to break that circle, and I think react now more robustly than ever. That's why we've called for a action of the Security Council, having Russia or getting Russia on board to
right.
give the Annan plan additional teeth. That's what Kofi Annan called for last week, that non-compliance
okay.
should not remain without consequences.
Okay,
that's what we've got to do now.
So, Ambassador, as we've been looking just at pictures while you've been talking to us about people allegedly being used as human shields in Syria, and this is really about getting Russia on board now. How will that be possible?
Well, we're having contacts on all levels, on the highest levels, between capitals here in New York. We follow the lead of Kofi Annan, who said that we have to have sustained international pressure on the Assad regime. And that's why we are working to get an agreement on getting teeth to that Annan plan. And once again, I repeat our suggestion that we have an independent commission of inquiry to look into those horrible facts that we have in front of us and the massacres that occurred, and to ensure accountability. That is what we need urgently.
Sure. But if I could just focus on Russia here, because really it seems that any unanimity or consensus within the UN Security Council depends very much on Russia. On a day when Hillary Clinton, the US Secretary of State, has said she is concerned about helicopter attack gunships being supplied by Russia to Syria and other matters. How do you realistically believe that Russia can be brought on board in terms of a consensus within the UN Security Council? How's it going to happen?
Russia has a decisive key for a resolution of this crisis in Syria. And we need Russia on board in order to be able to exhaust all possibilities for a political solution. That's what my country and other countries are working on these days. And we hope that this serious aggravation of the situation convinces Russia that it has to come forward to wield its influence on Damascus.
In a time when the international community is divided on the use or not of military action intervention in Syria, your country is against it very much so. Let me ask you, do you think that there is still time for diplomacy to work?
Yes, there is a diplomacy at work as we speak, and we believe that all possibilities should be exhausted. I have, quite frankly speaking, not heard anybody in the Security Council voicing any preference for a military solution. So I think everybody is working hard on a political solution.
And finally, do you believe, Ambassador, that that will come, that solution which so crucially needs the involvement and the backing of Russia?
there's no alternative to that that I can see. That's why we've got to put all our energy to find that solution.